because we're writers or mm-hmm. people are graphic artists or podcasters, whatever. You can do that from anywhere. So that's changed, and the governments have kind of reacted to that because I think a lot of them have realized that that's a very desirable demographic to bring in, because these people are earning money and they're not using a lot of services. Mm-hmm. They're not usually taxing the medical system. You know, they don't have kids in school a good bit of the time. So a lot of countries, I think it's up to 31 now, offer some kind of mm-hmm. digital nomad visa. Some of them are more desirable than others. Some of them are in expensive countries like Iceland, where it's not going to help you too much to move there from the US or England. You're going to actually be spending more than you did before. But a lot of them are in cheaper countries too. So I'm happy to see that development, because it means you can go somewhere for more than 3 months, because that's usually the cutoff for a tourist visa.